Hi, in this tutorial, we are going to make an ice material. First, import the texture uploaded to the video into the project, create the material and click to open the window. Set the blend mode to translucent and lighting mode to surface translucency volume. Next, hold down number 3 on the keyboard and click to create two content 3 vectors, set one color to dark blue and the other to light blue. Then, hold down L on the keyboard and click to create the Lerp node. After creating a Fresnel node, press S on the keyboard and click to create two parameter nodes. After setting name and value of the parameter nodes you created as in the video, connect them to the Fresnel node. Next, create the clamp node and connect it to the Fresnel node. If you set the max value of the clamp node to 0.5 and preview the clamp node, you can see that the material is divided into gray at the center and white at the rest. Once confirmed, connect two constant 3 vectors and a clamp node to the previously created Lerp node like the video. Next, create the texture sample node by clicking while holding down T on the keyboard. Set the rock slate normal provided by start content. Next, create the text chord node and click while holding down the M on the keyboard to create a multiply node. Then, create a parameter node and set a value so that the UV of the texture can be adjusted with the instance. Now connect the text chord node and the parameter node to the multiply node, and then connect the multiply node to the texture sample node. When you connect the texture sample node to the normal node of the material, the normal of ice material is completed. Next, copy the multiple nodes connected to the normal texture sample. Next, create the bump, offset node and parameter node, set the parameter node value to a negative value, and connect the copied nodes to the bump, offset node, and parameter node. Next, create two texture sample nodes and set one to the first imported texture, the other to the pearl and noise texture provided by start content. And connect the bump, offset node to UV pins of the two texture samples. Additionally, after creating the subtract node, set the value to 0.5 and connect it to Perlin Noise Texture to reduce the white part of the Perlin noise a bit. Next, hold down on the keyboard and click to create an add node. Connect the texture sample node and subtract node to the add node. When you preview the add node, it looks like the texture has been pushed in by the bump offset. After creating the power node, connect it to add node. Next, create a lerp node and a constant 3-vector node. Convert the constant 3-vector node to a parameter node and set the color to a light white color. Next, create a Fresnel node and connect the Fresnel node, power node, and constant 3-vector node that you just created to the lerp node. Now, when you preview the lerp node, you may see the material looks like an ice with a crack inside. After creating the multiply node, set the multiply value to 0.5 and connect it with the lerp node to reduce the brightness of the lerp node. Next, create the add node and connect the multiply and lerp nodes to the add node. And by connecting the connected add node to the emissive node of the material, the ice material is completed. Finally, create 3-parameter nodes and connect them to metallic, roughness, and opacity of the material to make them to be adjusted by instance. Save and return to the content browser. Right-click on the ice material to create a material instance. Then, place the desired static mesh in the level from the Place, Actor window or from the Props folder in Start Content. After setting the Material Instance to the Place Static Mesh, click Material Instance to open the window. You can adjust the parameter by checking the checkboxes of the parameter group in the parameter window.